Good morning, student. In the last classes, we have seen the questions of chapter differential equation. We have seen all the methods, variable or separable method, homogeneous method, and linear differential equation method. Now, student, today we are going to start new chapter with three-dimensional geometry. Okay, and we will see some questions of your board examination. Okay, so let's see. First question is, find the value of lambda of the line 1 minus x by 3 is equal to y minus 2 by 2 lambda, which is equal to z minus 3 by 2 and x minus 1 by 3 lambda is equal to y minus 1 by 1, which is equal to 6 minus z by 7. Find the value of lambda so that line this and this are perpendicular to each other. Okay, student. So this is our question. These are the equation of two lines, and we have to show that find the value of lambda. Okay. Now, student. So what we will do? So first we will write. We will take negative sign here. We write x minus 3, x minus 1 by 3, y minus 2 minus lambda by 2 lambda, z minus 3 by 2, and this equation is. This equation is also we will change. This is 3 lambda y minus 1 by 1 and this is z minus 6 by minus 7. Okay, and you know that if the two lines are perpendicular, then their direction, then we can say that a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 is equal to 0. a1 b1 c1 is the direction cosine, direction ratio of this. So we can write direction ratio of lines of 3, 2 lambda 2 and 3 lambda 1 and minus 7. So if the two lines are perpendicular, therefore we can write if two lines are perpendicular, then we can say that 3 into 3 lambda plus 2 lambda into 1 plus 3 into 2 into minus 7 is equal to 0. 9 lambda plus 2 lambda minus 7 is equal to minus 14 is equal to 0. And this is our 11 lambda. Okay. Sorry, here is minus, so it will be with minus sign. And here is minus 9 lambda minus 2 lambda is equal to 14 and lambda is equal to minus 7. Here is 7 lambda and this is minus 2. Okay, student. Now we see next question. The next question is, find the equation of plane passing through the point minus 1, 2, 1. So next question is, find the equation of plane passing through the point minus 1, 2, 1 and perpendicular to the line joining the point minus 3, 1, 2 and 2, 3, 4. Okay, so equation of plane passing through one point is equation of plane passing through minus 1, 2, 1 clearly you know student, equation of plane passing through point x1, y1, z1 is a x minus x1 plus b y minus y1 plus c z minus z1 is equal to 0. So here x1, y1, z1 is minus 1 to 1. So equation of plane will be what? A x plus 1 plus b y minus 2 plus c z minus 1 is equal to 0. This is our equation of plane. This is equation number first. And now the question says that find equation of plane and perpendicular to the line joining the point this and this. So we have given the coordinate of two points minus 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we have to find the line which is passing through these two points. Okay, so equation of line passing through these two points 3, 1, 2 and 2, 3, 4 is given by x minus x1 upon x2 minus x1, y minus y1 upon y2 minus y1, z minus z1 upon z2 minus z1, which is x plus 3 by 5, y minus 1 by 2 and z minus 2 by 2. So this is the equation of the line which is passing through these two points. Now student, and student question says that this equation is perpendicular to this line. Okay, so equation of plane is perpendicular to this line, either this plane is this line is perpendicular to this plane. So you know the normal of the plane is always perpendicular to the plane. Okay, already perpendicular to the plane, and this line is perpendicular to this plane. So this normal is parallel to this plane. So we can write the plane 1 is perpendicular to the line 2. Okay, so direction ratio will be parallel. So we can write a by 5 is equal to b by 2 is equal to c by 2. Let this is equal to lambda, and a is 5 lambda, b is 2 lambda and c is 2 lambda. Now we put this a, b, c in this equation and we find the whole equation of plane. Okay, so put, so we write from 1 a which is 5 lambda x plus 1, b 2 lambda y minus 2, c 2 lambda z minus 1 is equal to 0. Now take lambda common from here and we will send this right hand side. So it will be 5x plus 5, 2y minus 4, sorry 2y minus 4 and 2z z minus 2 is equal to 0. 5x plus 2y plus 2z, 5, so this is minus 1 is equal to 0. Now this is the required equation of plane. Okay student, which is 5x plus 2y plus 2z minus 1 is equal to 0. I hope you understand. Student, we have to say that in this question, find the equation of plane which is passing through this point and perpendicular to the line joining these two points. Okay, so what we have done in this question, first we have write the, we know the equation of plane passing through one point is a x minus x1 plus b y minus y1 plus c z minus z1. Now we write the equation of plane a x plus 1 b y minus 2 c z minus 1 is equal to 0. This is first equation, which is our equation of plane. Now we find the equation of line which is passing through two lines. So we know the formula is x minus x1 by x2 minus y1, x2 minus x1, y minus y1 is equal y minus y1 upon y2 minus y1 is equal to z minus z1 upon z2 minus z1. Then we will put here and find the equation of line which is 2. And question says that this plane is perpendicular to this line, and you know the direction ratio of the plane is perpendicular to the plane. So A, B, C are the direction ratio which is perpendicular to the plane, and this line is also perpendicular to the plane. So we can say that this direction ratio will be parallel to the direction ratio of the normal direction ratio of the line. So so we can write A by 5 is equal to B by 2 is equal to C by 2, which is equal to, we have taken constant lambda. So A, B, C is 5 lambda, 2 lambda, 2 lambda. Now we put this value of A, B, C in the equation first, and we get our equation of plane. After solving, we are seeing that our equation of plane is 5x plus 2y plus 2z minus 1 is equal to 0. I hope you understand this means. Now we take another question and solve it. Let's see. Find the coordinate of point where the line through the point this and this crosses the plane. Okay, so there are two coordinate, 3, 4, minus 4, minus 5, and B is 2, minus 3, 1. Okay, we have to find the coordinate of the point where the line passing through this point crosses the plane. Our plane is 2x plus y plus z is equal to 7. So students, suppose that this is our plane whose equation is 2x plus y plus z is equal to 7. So we have to find the equation of that plane which is passing through the point A is 3 minus 4 minus 5 and B is 2 minus 3, 1. Okay? So we have to find out the point of intersection of the plane which is let this is P, which is alpha, beta and gamma. So our target is to find out the coordinate of point P. Okay? And this is the line which is whose coordinate is A is 3 minus 4 minus 5 and B 2 minus 3, 1. So this line crosses this plane at the point P, and we have to find the equation of find the coordinate of that point P. Okay student, so first of all we will find out the equation of line AB which is passing through the point this and this. Okay, so equation of line AB is what? X minus x1 by x2 minus x1, y minus y1 by y2 minus y1, z minus z1 upon z2 minus z1, z2 minus z1. Okay student, now we will solve it and write x minus 3 by minus 1, y plus 4 by 1 and z plus 5 by 6. Okay, now student, this is the equation of line which is line AB, and this line intersects the plane at the point P. So this point P alpha beta gamma satisfying the line. Okay, so we write alpha minus 3 by minus 1, beta plus 4 by 1 and gamma plus 5 by 6. This is question number 2. Now student, we will suppose that this is equal to lambda, okay, and we will find the general point. So general point is minus lambda plus 3 and beta is lambda minus 4 and gamma is 6 lambda minus 5, okay. This is our general point and this coordinate of general point is point P. Now this point P also satisfies the plane, so we can substitute the value of this alpha beta gamma. So we can write first, this is the equation of plane, which is A, and alpha beta gamma satisfy the plane. So we can write 2 alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to 7. Now we write alpha beta gamma here, so we get 2 minus lambda plus 3 plus lambda minus 4 and 6 lambda minus 5 is equal to 7. So we should write minus 2 lambda plus 6 plus this is 7 lambda minus 9 is 7 and 7 minus 2 is 5 lambda and this is minus 3 which is 7 and this implies lambda is 10 by 5 which is equal to 2. So we are getting our lambda is equal to 2, student. Okay, now we find out our this point alpha. Alpha is minus lambda plus 3 which is minus 2 plus 3 which is 1 and beta is lambda minus 4 2 minus 4 which is minus 2 and gamma is 6 into 2 minus 5 is 12 minus 5 which is 7 and 1 minus 2 5 is the coordinate of point P, which is 1 minus 2 5. Okay, so let's see once again student, we have to given two points A and B and this line joining these point, these two point passing through the plane and intersect at the point and we have to find out the coordinate of that point. Okay, so student, what we will do, first we will find the equation of this line. We have find out x minus 3 by minus 1, y plus 4 by 1, z plus 5 by 6 is equal to equation first this is, and this is our equation first, which is equation of line. Now we are seeing that this line AB intersect at the point P whose coordinate we have taken alpha beta gamma. So this point satisfies the equation of line also. So we can write alpha minus 3 by minus 1, beta plus 4 by 1, gamma plus 5 by 6 is equal to lambda. This is equation number 2. So alpha is minus lambda plus 3, beta is lambda minus 4, gamma is 6 lambda minus 5. Okay student, and this is the general point on this line. Okay, now this alpha beta gamma also satisfy the equation of plane because this coordinate is at the plane intersection point of line. Okay, so this satisfy also the equation of plane. So we write 2 alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to 7. Okay student, now we put the value of alpha beta gamma here and find out our lambda is 2. After getting the value of lambda is 2, we put this lambda in alpha beta and gamma and we get our coordinate of point P, which is 1 minus 2 5. I hope you understand students. Now we see another question. Let's see. Our next question is, student, find the shortest distance between the two lines. Okay. So our first line is R is equal to I plus 2j plus 3k. I plus 2j plus 3k plus lambda I minus 3j plus 2k. This is first equation of line, and second line is vector R is 4 plus 2 mu I, 4 plus 2 mu I plus 5 plus 3 mu plus j plus 6 plus mu. Okay, so this second equation first we write in the form of ijk. Okay, so this is 4i and 5j and 6k plus mu 2i 3j. Plus k. Okay. So vector R is 4i 5j plus 6k mu 2i plus 3j plus k. Okay. Now we know that shortest distance is modulus of a2 minus a1 dot b1 cross b2 by magnitude of b1 cross b2. Student, this is the formula of shortest distance, okay, which is a2 minus 7 dot b1 cross b2 magnitude of b1 cross b2. Now we find out first a2 minus a1. Our a2 minus a1 is, this is a1 plus a1 plus lambda b1, a2 plus lambda b2. So subtract this 4i 5j 6k minus I 2j plus 3k, and we get what? 3i minus 3j plus 3k. And b1 cross b2 is I j k, and r is equal to a1 plus lambda b1, which is 1 minus 3 2. B2 is 2 3 1. Now expand this I, which is minus 3 minus 6 minus j 1 minus 4 plus k 3 plus 6, and this is minus 9i and plus 3j plus 9k. Okay, now our b1 plus b2 is minus 9i plus 3j plus 9k. Now we will find the magnitude of this b1 cross b2 is under root 81 plus 27 plus 81. So this will be what? 1 and 2 and 7, 9, 8 and 8, 16 to 18 and 1, 18 just. So it is 189. Okay, student. and this is square of this 3 will be what? 9. And this is 9 and 2, 11. And 8 and 8, 16. 1, 17. Okay. Now, we will put all the value in the formula of shortest distance. We get what? A2 minus 7 is 3i minus 3j plus 3k. This is n dot b1 plus b2, which is minus 9i plus 3j plus 9k. And b1 plus b2 is under root 171, which is 27 minus 9. Now student, we will write 6 is 9 and 9 is 27, and by under root 171. Okay, so this will be cancelled and we write 9 by 171. Okay. Now this will be your shortest distance. Okay students, let's see once again what we have done overall in this question. We have to given r is I plus 2j plus 3k plus lambda I minus 3j plus 2k. And our second line is vector r is mu 4 plus 2 mu I 5 plus 3 mu j and 6 plus mu k. Okay. So first we will change this in the form of this, because we know the equation of line in vector form is r is equal to a plus lambda b. So first we will change this in the form of this. So we write 4 plus 4 I plus 5 j plus 6 k, and this is 2 I and 3 j and k, and this is outside mu. So this is r is equal to a plus mu b. So this is also type of line. Now we know the shortest distance between two lines, which is a2 minus 7 dot b1 cross b2 and magnitude of b1 cross b2, okay, and whole magnitude. So first we know that this is our r is equal to a1 plus lambda b1, and this is r is equal to a2 plus mu b2. So our shortest distance is this a2 minus 7 and b1 cross b2. So first of all, we will find out our a2 minus 7 and b1 cross b2 from the given information. Okay, so a2 minus 7 will be what? A2 is this, we have written this, and a1 is this, a1 is this. Now we subtract 4i minus i 3i, 5i minus 2j 3j, and 6 minus 3, so it will be 3k. Okay, so this is our a2 minus a1. Now we find b1 plus b2, which is I, j and k. So 1 minus 3, 2, 2, 3, 1, this is b1 plus b2. And now we expand this determinant, we get I, this will be minus 3 minus 6 minus j, it will change in 1 minus 4, and this k, it will be cancelled and we get 3 plus 6. Okay student, now we write minus 9i plus 3j and 9k, and now we will find our magnitude of this b1 plus b2. So it will be 81 plus 9 plus 81 again, and this is our under root 171. Now we all put these values in the shortest distance formula. So we get shortest distance is a2 minus 7, which is 3i plus 3j plus 3k here, and our b1 cross b2 is minus 9i plus 3j 9k we are putting here, and the magnitude of this is under root 171. Now we take dot product, we get minus 27 and 3 is a 9 plus and plus 27, this will be cancelled student, and we get our shortest distance, which is 9 by under root 171. I hope you understand, students. So thank you so much.